Hi, this is Sting.
Yo, this is Shaggy.
And we're here to answer some questions. We're both qualified clinical psychologists, so please fire away.
Dear Shaggy, my friend just got caught cheating on his girlfriend with the girl next door, and he's come to me for advice. For some reason, I feel like you would have good input on how I should help him. Signed, asking for a friend. I swear.
You need to go back to your girlfriend, get on one knee, and beg like you've never begged before.
I would say both knees.
On both knees.
Yeah, both knees.
Beg. You need rose petals. You need everything. You need to get up and be like, you know, cutting her toenails, soaking her in tubs, whatever it is, just to get back in the house. Do not follow some idiot talking about it wasn't me. That's stupid. It's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. Seriously, I'm still on the couch.
Dear Shaggy and Sting, my wife and I are sexually out of sync. She likes morning sex. I like getting busy at night when she's always beat. How can we get back on the same page? Help! Asynchronous lover.
We just gotta make time, bro.
It's gonna make time. I mean, we're not talking tantric sex here. We're just talking, you know, a bit of affection.
Lunch. We can do lunch.
Yeah.
Yeah, we can do lunch.
How do you get on the same page?
Lunch.
That's difficult. I think you really have to make time. Maybe in between.
Lunch.
Dear Shaggy and Sting, I'm a real foodie, and I've been dating this guy who I really like, but every time we go out for a burger, he asks for his with no bun. I find it deeply off-putting. Am I being silly, or is this no bun sitch a red flag for deeper incompatibility? Best, constantly craving carbs.
I don't think anybody is without quirks. Any life partner you have will always have something that's slightly difficult to deal with. But that's what relationships are for, you know, dealing with things that
make... You gotta have compromise.
Compromise.
Really. That's the
only word I was looking for.
Yeah, you compromise. That's the way to, you know, there's things that are deal breakers, but you gotta figure, you know, what
negotiation
works.
Negotiation and patience.
Yeah, patience. I could do without some things. I really don't want to see the number two close the door. I mean...
Okay. How long have you been married?
Well, I've been with my wife 20 years. But, you know, I still don't want to see... certain things.
Yeah, all right, okay, I get it. Yeah. Keep the romance.
Okay.
Yeah.
Dear Shaggy and Sting, I'm an avid dating app user. Once, I had 12 dates in a week. I generally take them to dinner, but the whole shebang is getting rather expensive. Should I reduce the number of dates I go on, or should I just hit them up with the DTF option right off the bat? Hopefully, the Tinder troubadour.
No, I don't like that.
Yeah.
12 dinners a week? You need to take 12 different people out to dinner every week?
That's expensive.
That's twice a night, almost.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's expensive.
I think the DTF should be secondary. I think having dinner and getting to know someone is the primary hooking up thing. And if the DTF thing happens, great. If it doesn't, then you found out about another
dinners.
Human being.
12 dinners? Was that McDonald's dinners? I mean, that's a lot to do for, you know, DTF.
I think you'd be TSTF. Too stuffed to fuck. Well, this is Sting and Shaggy thanking you for your very illuminating questions. I hope we answered them to the best of our ability.
And to your satisfaction.
We're very serious about it. We're not being flippant here.
Yeah. Very serious about it.
I eat buns.
What the fuck right now?
I do. I like them. I don't get fat.